There's been a long history of city initiatives and goals to finish the Manhattan Waterfront Greenway. It's this 32.5-mile loop around the island of Manhattan. The East Midtown Gap, running from 60th Street to 41st Street, is one of the hardest spots. The remaining gaps in the entire Greenway are the hardest gaps. So this project adds 1.5 acres of new land to the East Midtown community. So it's an acre and a half expanded access to the water. This neighborhood here, we are overlooking the water. This is a lovely park, but this neighborhood actually has some of the least park space per capita in Manhattan. This neighborhood does. And so we're actually bringing a whole new park to this neighborhood.
The project itself is a public park with a transportation corridor for the bikeway and a 10-foot walkway. The in-water structure consists of 100-foot span tub girders, four of them across, to create the 40-foot width, which are supported by caissons and a precast and a cast-in-place component to the pile cap. We have a trench drain that collects rainwater and distributes it into the soil cells beneath the bikeway to ensure that the trees on the project have the water and are able to thrive as they grow. Our structural engineers from Stantec needed to design a structure that could support the tree and the associated soil volume. And so it was really important to make sure that the structural design minimized any obstruction to views from Manhattan and created kind of a beautiful and elegant structure on its own.
So the structure we're standing on now, from day one, we knew we were going to have to make as much of it out of precast as we could. We knew we were going to have to do as much as we could by the waterfront, bring things in by barges. We ended up finding a waterfront property in Brooklyn that allowed the bridge to be shipped and then assembled on a barge and brought in on January 8th and erected very successfully overnight.
There was so much logistics ahead of time that our Skanska team worked with us and worked with DOT for the closure of the FDR and the actual technical components of picking up the bridge and setting it. So that was obviously one big milestone.
Resilience and sustainability were fundamental to the design of the project.
Coastal resilience is a huge issue here in Manhattan. We certainly had Hurricane Sandy, Superstorm Sandy, I should say, 8 or 9 years ago. The water rose about 8 feet.
And I think it gave everybody a real wake-up call to think about, you know, what is climate change and what is sea level rise? What is it going to do to my community? This East Midtown Greenway project has done a great job of creating that public open space along the waterfront that will have, you know, a long life in the city as the climate does change. It gives us a great, you know, example of waterfront access that could be deployed across North America, you know, even lakefront, riverfront, oceanfront.
It's going to be basically a catalyst to part of the restoration of this east side of Manhattan with respect to the infrastructure.
I love being part of this project. I tell all my friends, everybody I can, I always try to explain what it is and blows everyone's mind what we're actually doing here right next to the FDR.
I hope to one day be able to bike and or run or walk around Manhattan.
I'm excited to be here. I'm definitely excited to show it off.